Namaste, welcome to Geeta's Kitchen. Today is a very long awaited recipe which many of you have eagerly asked me for, and that is an instant chutney premix. See, all of us love chutney, especially with idli, dosa, vada, we love our chutneys. And very often when I speak to today's generation, they tell me, Amma, I love chutney, but the problem is in the place I stay, we don't get fresh coconut. Another person says, Ma, I love chutney, but you know, morning is so busy, especially with this work from home, and these kids also have to take care of. There is just no time to sit and grate the coconut and make chutney. There may be some bachelors also who want to make something, very quickly and only small quantities. So for them also, today I am going to show you how to make an instant coconut chutney in just 30 seconds.
Najamava?
Yes, absolutely. Just 30 seconds.
Okay, your time starts now.
Just watch. This is my chutney premix. Whenever you want to make chutney, just take out the required quantity of premix. I am just taking out 2 tablespoons today. Add curd and mix it well together. You can add a little more curd to adjust the consistency. See, our perfect chutney is ready with all the tempering, curry leaves, perfect texture, taste and consistency. For making this chutney, we are using this roasted gram or bhuna chana, and this is copra powder or dry coconut powder. This is readily available in the stores and also online, you can get it easily. I am also going to use some dry ginger powder, hing or asafoetida, a few green chilies and curry leaves, and finally just some tempering with mustard seeds and urandam. Now let's see how to make it. So this roasted chana chutney dal, we'll just dry roast it for a couple of minutes. Dry roast it over a low flame. It should not change color, but if it becomes hot to touch, that is enough, because we just want to make it crisp, that's all. And now add this dry coconut powder. I'm taking 3 cups. Whichever cup you take, use the same measure. 1 measure of roasted gram and 3 measures of this copra powder. Keep the flame very low on sim and dry roast this also. This coconut also should not change color, but just lightly dry roast it and keep stirring, otherwise it will tend to burn. So do it carefully. Now we can switch this off and we will remove it into a bowl. Let it come down to room temperature. Next, heat 1 tablespoon oil in a pan. Add the chopped green chilies. Wash the chilies, dry them very well with a cloth, cut it and add it to the oil. See, we are frying the chilies because we don't want any moisture to spoil the premix. So now roast or fry these chilies well in oil so that there is no moisture at all. See, the chilies are fried well, nice and crisp. There is no moisture. Now add it to this mix. To this, I am also adding about 1/4 teaspoon of dry ginger powder. And this is hing powder. This also you can add about 1/4 teaspoon. When all this is cool to room temperature, we will grind it in the blender jar. Now we are ready to grind this. when you grind, don't run the mixie for a long time. Just run it in short pulses, because you don't want a very fine powder. You want a slightly coarse texture typical of the fresh coconut chutney. See, we have ground it. Just see the texture. Now we'll add the required quantity of salt to it and mix all the ingredients well together. Now in the remaining oil in which we fried the chilies, don't add any additional oil. In that same oil, heat the oil, add a spoon of mustard seeds and allow it to splutter. Add half a teaspoon of urad dal. And two whole dry red chilies in it. Add it to the chutney mix. Next, adding a few fresh curry leaves to this. Dry roast the curry leaves also. See, roast these curry leaves also till they lose all their moisture and they are crackly crisp. Switch it off and add these crisp curry leaves also to the chutney. See, that's how crisp they should be. Now mix all the ingredients well together. We have added the salt, we have added the tempering. Here I have some steaming hot idlis ready. So we can quickly make the chutney. You have your chutney premix ready. So whenever you want to make, just take out the required quantity of this in a bowl. To this, add some curd. Mix it well. Add some more curd to adjust the consistency of the chutney. See, perfect chutney with the perfect texture, taste, consistency. See, our instant chutney premix is ready. So whenever we want, we just add some curd, mix it, and your chutney is ready. Here are your steaming hot idlis. The recipe for this idli malagapadi I have already given on my channel. Now we will serve it with this instant chutney. This premix will stay good outside on your kitchen shelf for about 2 weeks. For a longer shelf life, please store it in your fridge. You can easily store it for 2 to 3 months also when stored in the fridge. Thank you for watching this video. I hope this will be useful to you, especially on your busy mornings. Please subscribe to Geeta's Kitchen. We'll meet again with another interesting video from Geeta's Kitchen. Thank you.